Hello again. Welcome to lesson 17. My name is Danielle and I'm excited to be back with you again today. Let's remember back to lesson 16 where we learned about, let's remember the word that mathematicians use. That's right, addition. We combined two smaller collections to make one larger collection, which we called our total. We noticed that the order in which we combined the collections didn't change the total. How did you go with your home task? How did you practice addition? I'd like to share what I did. In my book, I used our cherry representation and I practiced addition with my stones. I discovered that 13 and 4 make 17. I also learned that 6 and 11 make 17 as well. 9 and 7 make 16. Even if I did 7 and 9, the total is still 16. Our learning intention for today is to explore the many ways to make 10, 15, and other amounts. You've already done a little bit of work with the facts of 10 with Claire. I've got a game to get us started. I'm going to use these post-it notes. If you would like to play this game at home after the lesson, you might have post-it notes too. Or you could make little squares out of a larger piece of paper. What we need to do is record 0 to 10 on one post-it each. Let's get started. 0. I'm going to place them once I've recorded up on the board here. You'll see why soon. 0. What comes next? Count with me. 1. I'm sure you know what comes next. That's right. 2. 0, 1, 2. Then comes 3. Lining them up in order. You guessed it. What comes next? 4. Now, when we write the digit 5, I'm going to do this 2 times. Any idea why? There's 1. And underneath, I'm going to do my second 5. Lining up. Then comes 6. 5, 6, 7. Now, when I write the digit 8, sometimes I get a little bit confused. So I say a little rhyme. You might know this as well. Make an S and do not wait. Don't forget to shut the gate. 8. 2 left. 9. And finally, our numeral, 10. Now, I need your help. Using our knowledge of the facts of 10, let's pair up to make 10. So, if I had 1, what would I add to make 10? That's right, 9, because 9 and 1 is 10. Let's keep going. 2 and, that's right, 8. 8 and 2 is 10. Let's try this one. 4. 4 and 6. 4 and 6 make 10. Do you know why I needed 2 fives? Because we know with our knowledge of doubles, 5 and 5 is 10. Our last 2, we know that 3 and 7 is 10. And finally, 0, because 10 and 0 is 10. Thanks for helping. I have a friend whose birthday is coming up, and I'd like to make her a gift. I'm going to make a necklace. Her favourite number is 15. So let's explore the different combinations to make 15. I've got some beads here, blue and yellow. Let's have a play. Now, I already know that 10 and 5 make 15. Now, I know she likes blue. I'm going to do the blue first. Count with me. 1. 2. That's right. 3. Then comes 4. Then comes 5. Halfway there. 5 and 5 makes 10. Counting 6. 7. 8. Great counting. 9 and 10. So if I've got 10 blue beads, how many yellow will I need to combine to make 15? That's right, 5. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's just check. I'm going to lay them out flat so I can count. Let's count. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and one more makes 15. So one combination of 15 is 10 and 5. Let's record that. How might we do this? We could, I'm going to do this, draw our long string. We know the total is 15. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's make our string a little bit longer. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So out of our 15, how many were blue? That's right, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's record 10. Now we know that if there's 10 blue, another 5 yellow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We know that 10 and 5 make, that's right, our total is 15. Uh-oh, I've noticed the yellow is a little tricky for you to see. Let's change it. Is that better? Can you see now? 10 and 5 is 15. What would this look like if we made a cherry representation? Up the top is our total. That's right, 15. And over here is 10. And on this side is 5. We know that 10 and 5 is 15. So we've found one combination of 15. Let's try another. I'm going to draw my string and my 15 beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 5 more. We know that. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now this time, I want more yellow. So let's have a try. What if we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 yellow. And on this side, that means there must be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So another combination, 8 yellow and 7 blue are another way of making our total 15. Now, your task at home is to do what I did. Have a go at finding as many combinations of 15 as you can. You might like to record like this, or you could use your cherry representations. Let's do one last one together. Here's our total, 15, and it's made up of 8 and 7. I wonder how many combinations of 15 you might find. If you're looking for a challenge, you might like to make a necklace with 20 or even 30 beads. What combinations might you find there? I can't wait to see how you go. Think about how you might record this. We know today we've had a go at representing like this, with our two collections and our combined total. Or the other way of representing is using our cherry diagram. What will you do? Thanks for joining me today. See you next time.